We'll see how to design this control circuit. This control circuit can be designed in two ways. Finally, the goal of control circuit is generating the signals, right? So we can design a circuit which can generate the signals. So that is hardwired control unit. There is a second one, that is micro-programmed control unit. We will see that later. Let me focus on the first one, the first model, which is hardwired control unit. In the hardwired control unit, we will be designing the circuit for the control unit. We will see that. First of all, you tell me, what is the purpose of control unit? To generate the signals, right? Which will direct the operations. Now, question number one, how this control unit should take the decisions? Depends on the some of the input, right? So now we'll see the inputs for this control unit. One is instruction register, you agreed, correct? So in instruction register, we will be taking opcode bits, right? So that means whether it is add, otherwise load, that will be decided by opcode. That's why we have to examine the opcode bits. Based on that, you know, there will be instruction decoder. So that decoder is going to take the input, which is nothing but opcode, and it will understand what kind of instruction it is. Okay. Now, based on that, that instruction decoder will generate some signals. Okay. I1, I2, I3, so on, IM. That signals are useful for your control signal generator. Okay. Now let me summarize. In instruction register, opcode bits will be processed by this instruction decoder, and the decoder understands what kind of instruction it is. Based on that, it will generate some input like I1, I3, I1, I2, I3, so on, IM. Let's say there are some of the bit patterns. Okay. Example, if it is add instruction, then maybe we generate a pattern like this. So that patterns will be taken as input by your control unit, and it will generate the control signals. Finally, indirectly, it is taking the input from instruction register. That is what I said. Second one, step counter. Sir, what is this step counter, sir? I will tell you. So in RISC kind of instructions, it is a simple model, right? We follow the 5-stage model, right? Stage one, we do something, fetching, then after that, we know that, right? Decoding, then after that, arithmetic, after that, memory, after that, store. So there are 5 stages, correct? Now, based on the stage, you know, some part of the circuit should work, right? If you are in first stage, then program counter should be incremented, correct? Similarly, memory should be accessed. That's why appropriately signals should be generated. Can I say one thing? Depends on the stage you have to generate the signals. That's why that step counter is going to give us the information about which stage we are now, which stage we are in now. Sir, how this step counter knows about which stage we are? Simple. Generally, if you design your system like this, example, let's say we will be, you know, for every instruction, there are 5 fixed stages, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If you design your machine such a way that in every stage, let's say you are taking exactly 1 clock cycle. Okay. Within 1 clock cycle, if you can generate, otherwise, if you can do the work of one stage, then each stage takes 1 clock. Sir, what if my stage is very lengthy? That means, example, let's say you are doing arithmetic. See, what if arithmetic takes lot of time, sir? Simply increase the clock length. That's it. Okay. So really, you want to plan your work so that every stage takes 1 clock cycle. Can you plan it or not is your question. Yes, we can plan it. Not a problem. Already I explained you, like, you know, why each one takes only 1 clock cycle. If it takes little bit more than 1 clock cycle, then increase the clock cycle. You are the designer. So increase the clock cycle period so that each operation, like that means each stage, the work of each stage can be carried out in 1 clock cycle. The only thing which you cannot do is that memory access, correct? Memory access sometimes takes 3 clock cycles, 4 clock cycles, correct? So assume that at this moment, I will discuss that later again. Don't worry. Let me assume that, let's say every time if you are getting the data in cache, 95% of the time you get it. Then within 1 clock cycle, we can access the memory. That's why the 4th stage also can be done in 1 clock cycle. The only thing is, what if the data is not available in cache? Then we have to wait for 3 or 4 clock cycles, right? That for that, what should be the solution? I will tell you that we will be dealing. Don't worry. Now in that way, so every instruction is taking 5 clock cycles. What we do is we use a clock generator. That clock generator should generate, you know, clock signals. So how to identify, you know, whenever a clock signal, I mean, so this clock is generating the timing. So what we do is, if you connect this clock to step counter, what this step counter should do is, whenever it is the first clock cycle in the computer, whenever you switch on the computer, let's say, let's start counting the clocks. Okay, assume that, you know, this clock is generating the clock like this. Clock 1, clock 2, clock 3, clock 4. Someone should count it. Step counter is going to count it. So, did you you know one thing? In our instructions, there is a periodicity, correct? What is that? In the first clock cycle, fetch, then decode, then after that ALU, correct? Recall, fetch, decode, ALU, memory, store, then again fetch, decode, in that way. So this step counter is going to generate 5 patterns like this: 0, then 1, then 2, then 3, then 4, then 5. In that way, assume that, let's say in digital you learn how to create a counter, correct? Now assume that, let's say this counter is going to oscillate between 0 to 5 like this: 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, again 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In that way, if this step counter generates this kind of patterns, then 0 can be used for the first clock, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, then again 0. Okay, then 0 can be used for fetch stage, 1 for decoding, 2 for ALU, 3 for memory, in that way, so we can use it. Now, that means, finally, sir, how this step counter should generate the numbers, like how often, I will tell you. For every system clock, it should be incremented. That means, you know, whenever one clock is done, that means, you know, one clock period is done, then it should be incremented. Such a way we can plan. That's why our system clock should be connected to step counter. So that for every clock period, so this clock will tick. Based on the tick, this step counter should increment its timer value. In that way, step counter is going to generate 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now this control signal, by seeing the binary patterns, example, assume that, let's say we have 5 bit. Of course, it is not required 5 bits. Let, for simplicity, we assume that we have 5 bits and that step counter is generating like this: 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, next 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, you know, that's 5. 5 bits are not required. If you have 5 bits, we use like this. 0, let us take only 3 bits, okay, 0, 0, 0, then 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, okay, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, after that again 0, 0, 0, and even 5 also not required, right, only 4, okay, 4, 1, 0, 0, then 0, 0, 0, again 0, 0, 1, in that way. So, if this step counter generates this kind of bits 0, 0, 0, that will be used as signals, and your control signal generator is going to, you know, understand that by these patterns, by seeing these patterns, now currently the system is having third clock cycle. System is now in the phase of fourth clock cycle, in that way. So your control signal generator can understand what is the situation. Is it a fetch stage, otherwise decode stage or ALU stage? Easily your control signal can generator can understand. That's why input should come from the step counter. Okay, sir, don't worry about the circuit creation now. It's not a big deal if you know digital electronics. Okay, at this moment, I'm just giving rough idea, high level idea. So finally, we have to take instruction register and we have to understand what kind of instruction, and we do that by this I1, I2, I3, so on signals. Now by this step counter, we understand what time it is now. It is a step fetch time, otherwise decode time, otherwise ALU time. Yes, by step counter we can understand. Now one more thing is conditional signals. Already I told you, whenever you do ALU operation, then some of the condition signals will be generated, correct? If you take them, example, N bit, Z bit, overflow bit, overflow bit V, correct? Recall. So using these bits, your instruction flow will change. That's why these conditional signals should be taken as input. And sir, is it not a complex circuit? Yes, it's a complex circuit. Because, you know, computer is not easy, designing the computer. That's why don't try to, by attending this lecture, don't try to create, you know, a computer. When you try to create a new computer by just understanding this lecture, then definitely you are not doing the right thing. We are first understanding the concept. Slowly, you know, to really create a computer, you need a lot of work. So these are all high level ideas, not exact ideas, okay? Now, external inputs also required sometimes. Example, let's say, some keyboard is generating an interrupt signal. That also should be considered, because based on that, your flow is going to be changed. That's why your final control signal generator should consider instructions, step counter, that means which stage you are, it will be decided by the step counter, that means clock signals and external inputs and conditional signals. See this counter enable bit. Sir, why this counter enable signal for the step counter? Everything we understood, but why this counter enable? Now please recall that memory interface. Already I told you, so when you have a memory interface, this is your memory, okay, and this is interface. Sometimes you can't access the memory in one clock cycle, correct? But what was your assumption? In the first clock cycle you want to do fetch, in the second clock cycle you want to do decode, in the third clock cycle you want to do execution, that means ALU, in the fourth clock cycle you want to access the memory. So at fourth clock cycle, when you are accessing the memory, what if that is not done in one clock cycle? Then this step counter will go to the fifth clock cycle, then control signals will be generated such a way that fifth clock cycle, that means, you know, writing operation will be done, right? After that again it will go to fetch cycle, but everything will be malfunctioned. The reason, really, fourth clock cycle's functionality is not done in one clock cycle because of the memory delay. That's why what we can do is we can disable this counter enable, that means we can, you know, make it zero. Whenever counter enable is zero, then step counter will not start, will not increment. Okay, example, let's say I will show with the example so that it will be easy. Step counter generates zero. Whenever step counter generates zero, then control signal will be properly, you know, will be generated, so that control signals will be generated, so that fetch will be done. After that one, after that two, after that three, after that four. So whenever this counter enable is zero at that time, see, what we do is whenever there is a memory delay, we struck here, we'll stop here, and after that we don't increment this counter. So what happens? After 4 we will be in 4 only, after 4 we will be in 4 only, so that this control signals will not change. Okay, now everything is same. Since control signals are not changed, then we will be stopping all the signals. That means, you know, I can say, so nothing will work, that means fifth stage functionality will not be generated by your control signals. When that will again re-happen? After some time, what happens? This memory interface is having one bit. Did you remember that signal? MFC, right? So that means memory function is completed. Whenever memory function is completed, this signal will be generated by from memory. So immediately counter will be enabled back. That means now we'll make it one so that it will start working. In high level idea, I will tell you, very simple. This counter enable will be enabled only when you really want to increment the counter. That means whenever you want to increment the clock. If you don't want to increment the clock, that means you don't want to do the next operation, then counter enable will become zero. Example like memory delay, then we will stall. This is called stalling. Okay, we stop everything. That means your circuits will not be, you know, will be completely stopped. No signal will be generated. So again, the next signals will be generated when this counter is incremented. This counter is incremented only when counter enable will become 1. But counter enable will become 1 only when this memory says that operation is done. So this memory is going to respond with a signal called MFC. So we can use that MFC signal here and we can enable and disable this step counter. That is what the idea. Understand? So this is about finally hardwired control unit, circuit functionality, and you know, everything.